Hey, what's up guys? You probably know that I love gimbals and I've been using my Crane 2 for the last 3 months and what can I say? I'm loving it. So today I thought I would make a video for you guys where I show you the accessories I have for my Crane 2. These accessories have made my life a lot easier and I cannot imagine myself shooting a video without these accessories anymore. They have helped me out a lot and I hope they will do the same thing for you. Anyway, whew. Here's my badass setup. This might look like much, but it's actually not. By the way, Nikon is just there for the attention because I'm using my main camera, Sony Alpha 6500, to film myself. Anyway, let's talk about the accessories I have on this bad boy. Let's start with the most important accessory ever. And you might be thinking it's the monitor, but no, that's the dual handle system, which is this little sturdy guy here. The reason why it is so important is because it just makes your setup a lot lighter. You know, sometimes when you're using the Crane 2 with just one hand, you get this kind of weird jittery movement going on, especially in orbit shots. But with the dual handle system, you will never have to worry about that problem ever again, because your shots will be so smooth. And overall, this has increased my productivity and now I'm not afraid to experiment with the Crane anymore, which is really, really good. I just love the fact that it makes your setup so much lighter for some reason, because now when I wake up in the mornings, I don't have to worry about my back or shoulders hurting because of overworking. And look, for the sake of this tutorial, I'll be holding the setup in my hands for the whole time. Dual handle system is just a pleasure to work with and I would recommend it to anyone, because you're gonna feel more proud of your shots and you will not have to worry about the jittery movement, which is awful, by the way. The second accessory, which might look like it doesn't really do anything, but it's super important, is this motion sensor remote. Now, here's the reason why I love it. It has all these crazy modes. G mode, which is, I think it was the gravity mode, where you can, you know, point the remote in different places and the Crane 2 will follow as well, which is cool. But for my style of filming, it's not really that necessary. But what I do use it for is the fact that you can change the modes and start recording by pressing these buttons on the remote. Here's the reason why it's super important. When you're filming weddings and events, you don't wanna be putting this on the ground all the time just to change the settings, the modes, and start recording. That's so annoying and you can miss shots by doing that. This is why I love this tool. Let's say everything is in lock mode, right? Everything is in lock mode and I want to switch to the follow mode. So all I do is just press twice on this remote, one, two, and look, now I'm in follow mode. And I didn't even have to put this on the ground and like kind of put this on my crotch or belt and I don't know, that's so annoying. Anyway, this tool is so great. It has made my life a lot easier and more convenient. And the third accessory, I bet you already guessed it, and it's the external monitor. Now here's the thing. If you're a Sony shooter, you are probably looking at small HD, right? Now it's a great monitor. I have played with it a bit, but here's the reason why I'm not getting it. $600, man. Like, what? $600 freaking. You can get this monitor for 2.5 times cheaper price, which is $250, I think it was. Here's the reason why this monitor is really, really good. Yeah, it doesn't have touchscreen, but I don't really need that because I rarely ever touch the external monitor because I have already set all the settings I want. And those are zebras, focus peaking, zoom in, and aspect ratios, different aspect ratios. And that's all I need, because what I care about the most when using this monitor is framing and focus. And this is just amazing. I set everything on the custom buttons here and it has helped me out a lot. And here's the thing, pro tip for you guys, if you wanna improve your framing, try putting a black and white filter or something on the monitor, so when you actually record, it's still recording the color, but all you see on the external monitor is black and white. Now, the reason why this is really helpful is because for some reason, it just improves your framing. You're not concentrating on the colors so much, but you're concentrated on the framing a lot. And that is really, really cool. And if you're in the middle of the day filming a wedding, you will not see anything on the screen anyway. So this external monitor has helped me a lot. And now I'm not that worried about exposing in rough daylight anymore. Anyway, these are the three accessories which has helped me a lot. And every single time I'm using this setup, I feel super stoked for for filming something with it. By the way, if you wanna mount this monitor on the Crane 2, I would recommend this magic arm. Anyway, these are the three accessories which have helped me a lot. I can't recommend you these accessories enough. They made my life a lot easier. I feel a lot more motivated to film stuff right now, and I don't get as tired as I did before. Soon I'm going to be making a video where I actually show the behind the scenes of how I'm working on bigger projects with this exact setup which I just showed you right now. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, guys, and as always, peace!